your only son Jesus die on the cross so that by his precious blood we can be saved.
因为爱你拣选了我们，让我们白白地得着这奇妙的救恩。
Because of your love, you chose for us to receive this amazing grace freely.
父啊，我们要赞美感谢你的爱。
Father, we give thanks to this great love and praise your name.
父啊，愿你常在我们里面，给我们力量，让我们能够各尽所能地和所有的人分享这一美好的信息。
Father, please remain with us, give us strength, so that we can share this with others.
今天早上，当我们的牧师传扬你的话语时，愿圣灵与他同在。
This morning, may the Holy Spirit be with our pastor when he shares your words with us.
我们也求圣灵洁净我们的心，好让你的话语住在我们里面。
May the Holy Spirit cleanse our hearts so that your words will remain in our hearts.
愿我们今天早上的敬拜能蒙你悦纳。
May this morning's service be acceptable to you.
我们如此祷告，是奉耶稣基督的圣名。
In Jesus' almighty name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
大家请坐。
Please be seated.
下面我们请陈牧师带领我们带祷。
Pastor John will now lead us in intercessory prayer.
大家早。
Good morning, everyone.
冷天快要过去了。
The cold days are about to pass.
我们为今天大家能够在一起向上帝献上感谢。
We give thanks that all of us can gather here together.
好，我们大家从左右边弟兄姐妹们握手说平安。
Let us greet one another, with a handshake and a greeting.
好，今天代祷的事项是为澳洲祷告。
This morning we will pray for Australia.
这几天长老会总会鼓励大家为澳洲政府祷告。
These few days the presbytery encourage everyone to pray for Australia.
我们特别为澳洲联邦政府祷告。
We want to pray especially for the federal government.
他们正在处理。以后这个婚姻的问题。
They are now making decisions about marriage in future.
求上帝给他们有勇气、有胆量，能够持守传统的婚姻。
Pray that they will have the courage and also to set the example for traditional marriage.
就是说，仍然是男的同女的结婚。
That means it would be for a man to marry a woman.
对，求上帝保守。
We pray for God's blessing.
给他们勇气，给他们智慧。
To grant them courage and wisdom.
我们也继续为身体欠安的弟兄姐妹们祷告。
We continue to pray for our brothers and sisters who are in ill health.
今天我们的姐妹刘慧清回来了。
Today our sister 慧清 is back.
上帝恩待她身体健康。
God has blessed her with good health.
也继续为 Chris 祷告 ，Chris 还在医院。
We want to continue to pray for Chris, who is still in hospital.
好，我们用一首诗歌预备我们的心，我们来唱《我的平安》。
Let us prepare our hearts by singing this song, My Peace.
给你，我将我的爱赐给。
给你，十分爱会是天所能给你，十分爱会是天所能够了解，却他只借他红，我将挚爱赐给你。
我们同心祷告。
Let us unite our hearts in prayer.
天父，我们在这里一同来敬拜你。
Heavenly Father, we come together to worship you.
这是因为上帝的爱吸引我们到你面前。
And that is because of your love that has attracted us to come before you.
也真正的知道你的名超乎一切万名。
And we know that your name surpasses all other names.
所以我们被你吸引。
And we have been drawn to you.
我们靠着你的恩典归入你的名下。
We rely on your name to come under you and to be yours.
天父上帝，我们为所居住的国家祷告。
Heavenly Father, we want to pray for this country.
我们看到人类道德的没落。
We can see the decline of moral values.
我们恳求上帝光照我们的心。
We pray, Lord, for your light to guide our hearts.
求上帝赦免我们一切的亏欠。
We ask, Lord, for your forgiveness for our.
我们离开了上帝。
We have fall away from you.
我们走自己的道路。
And we have gone on our own path.
我们求上帝再次怜悯我们。
We ask, Lord, for your forgiveness.
我们特别为澳洲联邦政府祷告。
We want to especially pray for the federal government in Australia.
在这么困难的处境当中。
Amongst this difficult circumstance,
求上帝给他们勇气，给他们智慧。
We pray for them to have courage and to have wisdom.
站在真理，站在道德这方面，为你做美好的见证。
That they will stand, on the side of being just and fair and to be your witness.
我们看到人类已经被世界的神弄瞎了心眼。
We can see that the people.Have become blinded by the gods of this world.
我们看不到上帝的荣光。
And we cannot see your light and your glory.
我们也看不到自己的需要。
And we cannot see our needs.
求上帝怜悯我们。
Lord, we pray for your forgiveness.
恩待这个国家。
Pray, Lord, for this country.
不但在经济上可以富强。
We pray that this country will continue to prosper.In wealth,
也同样在道德灵性的生活可以富强起来。
And they will also continue to grow and mature in the moral values.
我们为身体健康的肢体们祷告。
We pray for our brothers and sisters who are not well.
我们继续为 Chris 在医院祷告。
We pray for Chris who is in the hospital.
他还在那里有一段的时间接受治疗。
He has been in a hospital for a period of time to receive treatment.
上帝给医生智慧。
We pray.For wisdom for the doctors.
给全家每一个人心中主的平安。
We pray for your peace amongst the family members.
我们再次看到上帝的作为显明出来。
Once again, we can see your mighty ways.
把荣耀归给我们的上帝。
And we give glory all back to you.
请问上帝，我们把今天的机会交托给你。
Lord, today we want to commit our gathering to you.
恩待大家，我们学习认识我们的上帝。
Please bless us as we come to know more about you.
更加信靠爱我们的上帝。
So that we can grow in our trust in you and love you.
奉耶稣基督的名。
We pray all this in the name of Jesus.
阿门。
Amen.
下面是聆听上帝话语的时间。
Let's now listen to the word of God.
今天我们要读的经文记载在新约希伯来书第六章从第三节到第十二节。
Please turn your Bible to the book of Hebrews, chapter 6, verses 3 to 12.
我们请台湾慧姐妹为我们国语读经， Alvin 弟兄为我们英文读经。
I will read in English and Mrs. Esther Sudin will read for us in Chinese.
读经完毕以后，有陈牧师证道。他今天讲到的题目是“初期与最后”。
After that, Pastor John will give the sermon, and the title of the sermon is
the beginning and the end.
Today's 所读的经文记载在《希伯来书》第六章从第三节到第十二节。神若许我们，我们必如此行。论到那些已经蒙了光照、尝过天恩的滋味，又与圣灵有份，并尝过神善道的滋味，觉悟来是全能的人，若是离弃道理，就不能叫他们重新懊悔了。因为他们把神的儿子从钉十字架明明地羞辱他，就如一块田地吃过驴吃下的雨水，生长菜蔬，合乎耕种的人用，就从神的福。若长荆棘和蒺藜，必被飞弃，今与咒诅，结局就是焚烧。亲爱的弟兄们，我们虽是这样说，却深信你们的行为强过这些，而且今后得救。因为神并非不公义，竟忘记你们所做的功和你们为他名所显的爱心，就是先前伺候圣徒，如今还是伺候。我们愿你们个人都显出这样的殷勤，使你们有满足的指望，一直到底，并且不懈怠，主要效法那些凭信心和忍耐承受应许的人。
Let's hear God's word. And God permitting, we will do so. It is impossible for those who have once been enlightened, who have tasted the heavenly gift, who have shed in the Holy Spirit, who have tasted the goodness of the word of God and the powers of the coming age, if they fall away,be brought back to repentance, because to their loss they are crucifying the Son of God all over again and subjecting him to public disgrace. Land that drinks in the rain often falling on it and that produces a crop useful to those for whom it is farmed receives the blessings of God, but land that produces thorns and thistles is worthless and is in danger of being cursed. In the end it will be burned.Even though we speak like this, dear friends, we are confident of better things in your case, things that accompany salvation. God is not unjust. He will not forget your work and the love you have shown him as you have helped his people and continue to help them. We want each of you to show this same diligence to the very end in order to make your hope sure. We do not want you to become lazy, but to imitate those who,to faith and patience, inherit what has been promised. This is God's word.
感谢主赐给我们他宝贵的话。
虽然是不容易了解的一段经文，
although this is a difficult passage to understand,
我想大家看了今天讲到的大纲，就可以给我们一个启示。
I think that when we have looked at the topic of today, you would have some better understanding.
这个最后是讲什么？
What the end is all about.
我把整个的经文读出来的时候，
When I read the whole passage,
我们看见好几个的对比，
You see a few comparisons,
开始和最后，
The beginning and the end,
这一类的对比，
Now this contrast,
有时候我们会失丧我们的信念感与热心，
Sometimes we will lose our freshness and enthusiasm,
好像在新约时代的基督徒一样，
It's just like the Christians in the New Testament.
特别这个希伯来的作者写给写信给他们的时候。
Especially when the author of Hebrews wrote to them.
他们正在遇到宗教信仰的逼迫。
They were facing religious persecution.
他们也遇到各样生活不同的困难。
And they were facing sufferings in their lives.
所以他们会失去新鲜感，像我们一样。
So they can lose their freshness just like us.
他们会失去热心，像我们一样。
And they can lose their enthusiasm just like us.
所以这本书不但是给希伯来基督徒的一个鼓励。
So this book is not just giving Christians in Hebrews.
也是给我们每一个人的一个鼓励。
But also an encouragement for all of us.
因为我们和他们一样。
Because we are just like them.
我们有时候会失去新鲜感。
Because we also can lose our freshness and enthusiasm.
想要跑不能够跑。
We want to run, but we can't.
想要走动也不能走动。
We want to move, but we can't move.
这就是我们失去热心的时候。
This is when we lose our freshness.
我们来看看这一段经文给我们的教导。
So let's look at the teachings from this passage.
开始的情形不能决定幕后的光景。审判是看幕后的结果。
Judgment is not determined by the beginning, but by the end.
记得不要把当初的情形来决定以后的结果。
So do not use the beginning to determine the end.
我们还要继续走动。
We still have to continue to move on.
永恒的事情不可能建立在短暂的日子。
Things that last are not built on temporary enthusiasm.
这是一个对比。
This is a contrast.
永恒的事情不能够建立在短暂的日程。
Things that last are not built on temporary enthusiasm.
试想而不是事实。
It's hypothetical rather than reality.
这是一个对比。
This is another contrast.
当我们读这段经文读到最后的时候。
So when we read this passage to the end,
告诉我们这到底是什么
？He will tell us what this is all about.
是一个假想呢，或是一个事实
？Is it a hypothesis or is it reality?
实际的情形不能决定幕后的光景，审判是看幕后的结果。
Judgment is not determined by the beginning, but by the end.
这是对我们每个人的鼓励。
This is an encouragement for all of us.
开始跑得好。
In the beginning, we run well.
不一定最后跑得好。
Doesn't mean that we will end well.
在开始跑得好。
So in the beginning, we run well.
我们还要继续跑得好。
We have to continue to run well.
最后我们才能够跑得好。
Then finally, we can run well.
主耶稣讲了一个比喻。
Jesus told a parable.
讲到这个败子和麦子的比喻。
The parable of the wheat and the tares.
就是一个人把这两种不同的种子都撒在田地上。
Farmer sows these two different types of seeds.
他们就问主人。
And they ask the owner.
现在要怎么样
？What do we do now?
这种子都撒在田地上了。
The seeds have all been sown on the ground.
这个比喻告诉我们。
This parable tells us.
撒种的主席，哪一个是麦子，哪一个是败子，都很难分辨。
It is impossible in the early stages to distinguish between the wheat and the tares.
当我们读这一段经文的时候，
So when we read this passage,
好像给我们这种的感觉。
It gives us this feeling.
到底是好的种子还是坏的种子？
Is this good seed or bad seed?
很不容易分别。
It's difficult to distinguish.
但记得最后才能够分别出来。
But remember, it can be distinguished at the end.
主耶稣的比喻告诉我们。
So the parable of Jesus tells us.
我们可以用这个比喻来了解这一段的经文。
We can use this parable to understand this passage.
我们来看看第六章第四节到第五节。
We will look at chapter 6 verses 4 and 5.
我们一起读吧。
As we read this together.
论到那些蒙了幻照，尝过天然的滋味，又与圣灵有份。
It is impossible for those who have once been enlightened.Who have tasted the heavenly gift, who have shared in the Holy Spirit,
并尝过神上道的滋味， 耶稣乃是全能的人。
Who have tasted the goodness of the word of God and the powers of the coming age?
这两节经文告诉我们什么？
What does these two verses tell us?
我们先看这个四个这几个字蒙了光照。
Let's look at these few words. Once been enlightened.
蒙了光照。
Once been enlightened.
了这个字。
This word, once.
告诉我们，这是最后的，也是绝对的。
It means a certain absoluteness and finality.
一个人蒙了光照以后
，someone who has once been enlightened，
就是说，已经做了。
It's been done.
不能够再来一次。
It cannot be repeated again.
已经是一个事实。
It's already a fact.
不能够改变。
It cannot be changed.
所以我们要从几个字这几个字开始。
So we want to use this word as a beginning.
来了解这一段的经文。
To understand this passage.
蒙了光照。
Once been enlightened.
有四个动词。
There are four verbs here.
都是在这两节的经文里面。
In these two verses.
一个是蒙了光照。
Once enlightened.
第二是尝过。
The next is tasted.
第三是有份。
The third is shared or become partakers.
第四是尝过神善道。
And the fourth is tasted the goodness.
这四个动词。
These four verbs.
告诉我们这个四个动词的下面三个动词是表达前面的一个动词。
It tells us that the latter three verbs is actually.Trying to express the first one.
So, 尽量把这一段的经文讲得简单。
So, I try to simplify this passage for you.
就是说，下面的三个动词加强了前面的第一个动词。
It is to say that the three verbs at the end is to serve to strengthen the clarify the first one.
意思说，蒙了光照什么意思呢？
What does it mean to be enlightened?
有尝过的意思。
It means.Having tasted,
有份的意思
or to have shared,
尝过神善道的意思
and to have tasted the goodness of the Lord.
这样子讲，我们对这段经文就比较容易了解。
So in saying this, it would help us to understand this passage better.
蒙了光照
enlightened,
讲的是光的来到。
It talks about the light having been shared.
圣经里面提到这个光用在主耶稣的身上。
In the Bible, the light is used in the Lord Jesus himself.
耶稣说，我是世界的光，跟从我的就不在黑暗里走，必要得着生命的光。
Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life.
是讲到他们曾经被光照。
It means that they have been enlightened.
他们曾经跟从耶稣基督。
They have followed.The Lord Jesus Christ.
另外，这个光也告诉我们
，Another light tells us，
此等不信的人，被这世界的神弄瞎了心眼，不叫基督福音的光照着他们。
The God of this age has blinded the minds of unbelievers, so they cannot see the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ.
我们就看见这个光。
So we see this light.
我们再回到希伯来书。
And then we come back to the book of Hebrews.
讲到蒙了光照。
And talk about having been enlightened.
就这一帮人曾经被光照。
Because these people have been enlightened.
本来心里的眼睛瞎了，看不见。
As initially, their spiritual eyes were blind and they can't see.
现在被光照看得见了。
But now they've been enlightened and they can see.
就跟从耶稣基督。
So they follow the Lord Jesus Christ.
所以这四个动词。
So these four verbs.
记得下面的三个动词是加强第一个动词。
Remember that the following three is to explain or strengthen the first one.
这是提到耶稣基督的启示。
And this talks about the revelation of Jesus Christ.
如果不是耶稣的光照我们
，If it's not because of His light having enlightened us,
我们就不会认识我们上帝。
Then we will not have known our God.
也不会。认识我们自己的需要
，and we will not know our own needs。
所以，这就是告诉我们这三个词 强化了的第一个动词。
So that's why this is the three verbs is strengthened by the three verbs strengthen the first one.
论到那些蒙了光照。
Having said about those people who have once been enlightened.
这就是说，被人的眼睛，被人开了眼睛，有看到自己那种迫切的需要。
Yeah, that is to have the eyes open to own desperate needs.
尝过天恩的滋味。
Having tasted the heavenly gift.
一个最起码，一个最根本的事实告诉我们。
Most basic fact tells us.
上帝爱我们，甚至将他的独生子赐给我们。
For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son.
我们尝过这个天恩的滋味。
We have tasted this heavenly gift.
这不是地上的东西带给我们的一种滋味。
This is not a taste from anything on earth.
是上帝爱我们，把耶稣基督赐给我们。
It is because God loved us and he gave us his son, the Lord Jesus Christ.
我们才能够尝到这一种的滋味。
So we can taste this heavenly gift.
也就是说，那些曾经单独与基督相遇的人。
So these are those who have known a person or who have a personal encounter with Jesus.
我们经历过福音是多么美好的一件事。
And have experienced how good the gospel is.
这就是说，尝过天恩的滋味。
And this is having tasted the heavenly gift.
又与圣灵有份。
And have shared in the gospel in the Holy Spirit.
表明我们领受了上帝给我们赐给我们的圣灵。
And that means we have received the gift of His enabling Spirit.
圣经告诉我们有关圣灵的教导。
And the Bible tells us about the teachings of the Holy Spirit.
一旦我们来到基督的面前，我们就成了分享或者有份于圣灵的人。
Once we come before the Lord, then we become partakers or sharers in the Holy Spirit.
并且尝过上帝上道的滋味。
Those have tasted the goodness of the word of God.
这是讲到我们因为进入上帝的应许，读了上帝的话语所带给我们的一种喜乐。
That means that we have entered into the joy of the promises of God.
觉悟乃是全能的人。
And the powers of the coming age.
讲到我们在地上经历一个神迹，就是在今生我们得到释放，我们得到拯救。
It means that we have already experienced the miracle of release and deliverance in the life.
我们都把这几节的意思告诉大家。
We are going to tell the meaning of these few verses.
就这些人已经蒙了光照。
These people have already beenEnlightened.
他们是尝过天恩的滋味。
They have tasted the heavenly gift.
他们是与圣灵有份。
They have shared in the Holy Spirit.
他们尝过上帝话语的喜乐。
They have tasted the joy of God's word.
他们经历上帝在他们生命中的作为。
They've experienced God in their life.
这一切都告诉我们，他们都蒙了光照。
All these.Tells us that they have once been enlightened.
当然，这个事情是非常好的一件事情。
Of course, this is a really good thing.
作者就把这个图画摆在我们的面前。
So the author has placed this picture before us.
当他把这个图画摆在我们面前的时候
，So when he placed this picture before us,
还有个期望。
He has an expectation.
因此，作者满心很热切地勉励凡尝过基督恩典的人。
So he is full of passion and is, the writer is concerned that those who have begun to experience the grace of Christ.
我们可以证明我们是真是信主的，并且要跟从主到底。
So that we can prove the genuineness by going on to the true end.
因为开始和最后是不一样的。
Because the beginning and the end is not the same.
最后的决定，一切的决定是在最后。
All the decision is at the end.
开始的时候
at the beginning,
蒙了光照
We have been enlightened.
但记得这不过是开始。
But remember, this is just the beginning.
我们还有继续。
We have to continue.
一直到最后。
To the end.
决定好不好？
And the decision if it is good or bad.
那是最后。
Is at the end.
第二告诉我们。
Secondly, it tells us.
永恒的事情不可能建立在短暂的热情。
Things that last are not built on temporary enthusiasm.
永恒的事情不能够决定在短暂的事情。
Things that last are not built on temporary enthusiasm.
我们都是和电视一起长大的。
We've been raised with the television.
昨晚看电视。
Last night we watched telly.
做礼拜之前又看电视。
Before we come to church service, we watched TV.
我们一直跟电视在一起一同长大。
We are always with television, growing up together with the television.
在电视的面前长大的人。
Those who grow up in front of the television.
只能够坐在沙发椅上面。
Can only sit on the couch.
不能坐在礼拜堂的椅子上。
Cannot sit in the pews of the church.
在沙发椅可以坐了两三个钟头。
You can sit for two or three hours on the couch.
但是在礼拜堂坐半个钟头就坐立不定了。
But sitting in the church pew after half an hour gets uncomfortable.
找理由要去洗手间。
So we find an excuse to get to the washroom.
这叫做在电视面前一起长大的人。
That is because we've been raised with the television.
一切都要快。
Everything we want to do it fast.
几十年的事情在电视那里就看到两个钟头罢了。
Things that have happened over the decades is all compressed in two hours.
所以陈牧师，你讲到半个钟头，我是忍受不住了。
So Pastor John, if you speak for half an hour, I can't stand that.
一切都要快，一切都要短。
Let's make it brief and short.
所以经常在电视面前长大的人。
So people who have grown up with the television.
就不容易坐在这里听上帝的话语。
It's difficult for them to sit here and listen to God's word.
但记得。永恒的事情不能够建立在短暂的日子。
So remember, things that last cannot be built on temporary enthusiasm.
我们这个时候是谈永恒的事情。
Now we are looking on things that are eternal, things that last.
在电视里面前是谈短暂的事情。
But in the television, they're talking about brief things.
我们不能够把永恒的事情建立在短暂的日子上。
So we cannot build things that last on temporary enthusiasm.
是第六节告诉我们。
So verse 6 tells us.
大家读。
Let's read together.
若是离弃道理，就不能叫他们从今懊悔了，因为他们把神的儿子从钉十字架，明明的羞辱他。
If they fall away, to be brought back to repentance because to their loss.They are crucifying the Son of God all over again and subjecting him to public disgrace.
刚才是一幅图画。
The picture before us just now.
现在是一句警告的话语。
But now it's just a sentence, a warning in a sentence.
非常的沉重。
It's a very stern.
若是离弃道理。
If you fall away.
就不能叫他们重新懊悔了。
It cannot be brought back.
因为他们把上帝的儿子从钉十字架，明明的羞辱他。
Because they are crucifying the Son of God all over again and subjecting him to public disgrace.
这一节是讲到高度浓缩的经文。
This is a highly compressed verse.
非常的严肃，非常的沉重。
It's very stern and serious.
指出了这些恶人的严重性。
So it indicates the seriousness of their offense.
他们把上帝的儿子重新钉十字架。
They have once again crucified the Son of God.
到底什么意思呢
？So what does this mean?
把上帝的儿子重钉十字架。
To crucify the Son of God afresh.
因为他们把上帝的儿子重钉十字架，明明的羞辱他。
Because to their loss, they are crucifying the Son of God all over again and subjecting him to public disgrace.
我们就记得在初期的教会他们流传 一个传奇的故事，题目叫做《主、驴和王》。
Remember, in the early church, there's this legend, the great Quo Vadis legend.
讲到罗马的皇帝开始逼迫基督徒。
When the Roman emperor began persecuting Christians,
很多基督徒就离开罗马城去逃跑。
And many people, many Christians left Rome to escape.
彼得也准备离开罗马城。
And amongst them, Peter was preparing to leave Rome as well.
当他正在沿着一条大路逃跑的时候。
And when he was fleeing on the road,
在路途上遇到一个人。
On the way, he met someone.
他觉得非常熟悉的一个人。
He thought this person was very familiar.
彼得就问他说：“主啊，你要去哪里？”
And Peter asked him, "Domine qua vadis, Lord, where are you going?"
主啊，你要去哪里？
Lord, where are you going?
原来是主耶稣。
It is the Lord Jesus Christ.
在他的面前。
Who is before him?
主耶稣回答说：“彼得，我要去罗马，为你的缘故受第二次的钉十字架。”
And the Lord Jesus said, "Peter, I'm going back to Rome to be crucified again. This time in your stead."
我要去罗马，为你的缘故受第二次的钉十字架。
I'm going back to Rome to be crucified again. This time in your stead.
彼得听到这句话。
When Peter heard this,
他知道自己的过错。
He knew what he has done wrong.
他不应该逃跑。
He should not flee.
所以彼得又再回到罗马。
So Peter returned to Rome.
彼得就留在罗马传福音。
And he stayed in Rome to spread the gospel.
一直到最后，彼得就被倒钉十字架。
Until finally he was crucified on the cross upside down.
是他的身体倒过来。
His body was placed upside down.
他觉得不配，好像主耶稣基督被钉十字架。
Because he felt that he was unworthy to be crucified like the Lord Jesus.
他在那里为主殉道。
And he was martyred there.
我们回到刚才那句话。
Let's return to the sentence earlier on.
把上帝的儿子重钉十字架。
To crucify the Son of God once again.
什么意思呢？
What does that mean?
就好像彼得一样。
It's just like Peter.
如果放弃这个信仰。
If he gave up his faith.
上帝的儿子重新还要再做一次。
The Son of God has to repeat what he has done again.
但不可能。
That's impossible.
但这里提醒我们。
But it reminds us here.
好像个比喻一样。
It's just a parable.
这个警告是非常的严重。
The warning is very severe.
当一个人放弃信仰的时候。
When someone gave up their faith.
就等于把上帝过去所做的事情把它取消了。
It's like deleting all the work that God has done for them.
把上帝的儿子重钉十字架。
And to crucify the Son of God once again.
明明的羞辱他。
And disgrace him publicly.
最后我们看这个教导到底是是想或者一个事实。
Finally, let's see if this teaching is hypothetical or is it real?
可能吗？
Is it possible?
一个人蒙了光照。
Someone who's once been enlightened.
以后还会羞辱上帝的儿子。
Would he again disgrace the Son of God?
可能吗？
Is it possible?
我不知道为什么这个苦难。
I don't know why tragedy.
能使一些人失去信心。
Which destroys faith in some people.
却又能使一些人生出信心。
Yet gives birth to it in others.
对一些人来说，这苦难把它打倒。
For some people, tragedy destroys them.
对另外一些人说，这苦难把他磨练，使他更刚强。
In others, it strengthened them and gave them, make them strong.
对希伯来的基督徒。
For the Christians, in Hebrews.
也有这种的情形。
There's also such circumstances.
对我们也有这种的情形。
For us, the situation is the same.
我们就看到有人被苦难打击，就慢慢退后。
We see some people hit by, struck by tragedy, and they go backslide.
有人面对苦难，经历苦难，自己更加刚强起来。
But some people in the face of tragedy become stronger and are strengthened.
California 有一间基督教的大学叫 Westmont College.
In California, there is a theological or Christian college called Westmont College.
这个校长叫做 Mr. David Winter.
And the president of the college is David Winter.
他在那里做了二十五年的校长。
He was a dean for 25 years.
President.
A president, sorry, for 25 years.
在准备退休。
And he was preparing for retirement.
就是等了一段的时间。
And in that time,
他突然间生病。
He suddenly was taken ill.
也在三个礼拜的时间。
And in 3 weeks.
这个病就影响了他的眼睛。
The illness affected his sight.
眼睛就失明了。
So he became blind.
退休了。
He's retired.
生病了。
And he's fallen ill.
失明了。
And lost his sight.
看不见。
He can't see.
当然很痛苦。
Of course, it's a tragedy.
毕业礼那一天。
So on the day of the graduation.
学校安排他。大学安排他上台讲话。
So the college arranged for him to give a speech.
有人就扶他。
Someone helped him up.
让他上来。
To the stage.
站在讲台上。
And on the stage.
他就对学生、对家长们讲话。
And so he spoke to the students and their parents.
他说：“不要因黑夜降临就心生怀疑，忘记了上帝。”曾经在光明中给你的指引。
And he said, never doubt in the darkness what God has shown you in the light.
啊，再读一次，不要因黑夜降临就心生怀疑，忘记了神曾在光明中给你指引。
Never doubt in the darkness what God has shown you in the light.
我们也记得过去上帝帮助我们。
We must remember how God has helped us in the past.
在光明的时候，他曾经帮助我们。
He has helped us walk in the light.
在黑暗的时候，他也仍然帮助我们。
And even in darkness, he has also helped us.
这句话非常的感动人。
And this sentence is very moving for us.
我们看第六章第七节到第八节。
Now we will look at chapter 6, verses 7 to 8.
告诉我们什么呢？
What does it tell us?
大家读。
Let's read.
就如一块田地吃过驴吃下的雨水，生长菜蔬，合乎耕种人之用，就从神得福。
Land that drinks in the rain, often falling on it, and that produces a crop useful to those for whom it is farmed, receives the blessing of God.
若沾荆棘的地里必被废弃，荆棘咒诅，绝地就是焚烧。
But land that produces thorns and thistles is worthless.And is in danger of being cursed, and in the end, it will be burned.
这是一个很生动的农垦生活里的比喻。
This is a very vivid parable drawn from agricultural life.
圣经常常用这个农田的生活来表达一些真理。
The Bible often uses parables drawn from agricultural life.
这里给我们看到。一个对比。
And here we can see a contrast.
一个好的田地，还有另外一个不好的田地。
Between a good land and bad land.
叫我们选择。
We're asked to make a choice.
我们看了一幅图画。
We've seen a picture.
我们听了一句警告。
And we've heard a warning.
现在让我们做一个决策，做一个选择。
So now we have to make a choice.
我们要选择好的田地。或者要选择不好的田地。
Do we choose the good land or a bad land?
当我们面对这个好的田地的时候。
So when we are faced with this good land.
这个教导常常提醒我们。
This teaching always reminds us.
我们知道上帝的恩典是好的。
We know that the blessings of God is good.
知道是一回事。
But knowing it is one thing.
我们能够去经历体验是另外一回事。
To experience it.Is another thing.
这是希伯来作者给我们一个提醒。
This is a warning or reminder that the author of Hebrews wants to give us.
我们看到一幅图画。
We've seen a picture.
蒙了光照的图画。
A picture of enlightenment.
我们听到一句警告的话。
We've heard a warning.
不要把上帝的儿子重钉十字架。
Not to once again crucify the Son of God.
明明地羞辱他。
And disgrace him publicly.
今天要我们做一个选择。
So now we have to make a choice.
我们要选择好的田地或者不好的田地。
Do we choose the good land or the bad?
因为希伯来的作者知道每个人的光景。
Because the author of Hebrews knows each one of our situations.
我们的属灵经验是停留在过去的记忆里面。
Because our vital Christian experience is only a memory of the past.
我们的属灵经验是停留在以往的记忆里面。
Our vital Christian experience is only a memory of the past.
过去那么热心。
So having been enthusiastic in the past,
过去做学生的时候是那么的爱主。
When we were students, we loved the Lord.
过去常常读圣经。
And we've always read the Bible in the past.
但这一些，这不过是停留在我们的记忆里面。
But this is only a memory of the past.
没有在今天的生活里面。
It's not in our life today.
我们要做一个选择。
So we have to make a choice.
如果是停留在过去的记忆里面。
If it is just a memory in the past,
我们要选择什么田地呢?
What kind of land would we choose?
过去的事情不能够决定今天。
Things that happened in the past cannot decide today.
今天我们一定要更新我们自己。
And today we have to renew ourselves.
因为永恒的事情不能建立在短暂的日期。
Because things that last are not built on the temporary enthusiasm.
我们要继续走动。
We have to keep moving.
不要让过去的属灵经验停留在记忆里面。
Do not let our vital Christian experience stay a memory of the past.
这个作者讲了很多话以后。
This author, after having said so much,
第九节就告诉我们。
In verse 9, he tells us.
大家来读。
Let's read this together.
亲爱的弟兄们，我们虽是这样说，也深信你们的行为强过这些。而且经过得救。
Even though we speak like this, dear friends, we are confident of better things in your case, things that accompany salvation.
我们读了这一节以后，
After having read this verse,
我们就会感觉到，
Then we can understand
前面的可怕，
The terror before,
那个很严重的警告，
That severe warning.
但这话讲出来以后，
But this verse,
这是一个恩惠的话语，
This is words of grace,
充满鼓励的话语，
and filled with encouragement.
他的意思是说，
It is to say,
你们不是像他们那个图画里面的人，
You are not like those people in the picture.
你们不会把上帝的儿子重钉十字架，
You won't crucify the Son of God again.
你们的情形好过他们，
Because you are better than those people.
你们的情形好过他们。
Because in your case, the things are better.
这讲到上帝的作为在我们的身上。
And this talks about God's work in our lives.
记得上帝爱我们就爱我们到底。
Remember that when God loves us, He loves us to the end.
上帝拯救我们就拯救我们到底。
He saves us.To the end.
我们不会被上帝放弃。
He will not forsake us.
他爱我们，爱我们到底。
He loves us and he loves us to the end.
他拯救我们，拯救我们到底。
And he saves us to the end.
我们不可能把耶稣基督重钉十字架。
We cannot crucify Jesus Christ again.
所以这里的作者对我们一个鼓励。
So the author is encouraging us.
这是一个假象，而不是一个事实。
As hypothetical rather than real.
当我们读希伯来书读到这一段的时候，
So when we read this passage of the book of Hebrews,
记得这是一个假象，不是一个事实。
Remember that this is hypothesis, not a reality.
作者用这个教导来鼓励我们。
The author used this teaching to encourage us.
鼓励我们什么呢？
What does he want to encourage us?
勉励凡尝过基督恩典的人。
To encourage that those who have begun to experience the grace of Christ,
要证明他们是真实信主的，并要跟从主到底。
should prove their genuineness by going on to its true end.
我们这一班尝过耶稣基督恩典的人，
for those of us who have tasted the heavenly gift of the Lord Jesus Christ,
我们要证明我们是真正信主的。
We have to prove that we sincerely, genuinely believe in the Lord Jesus.
我们要跟从主到底。
We should follow Him, going on to its true end.
我们低头祷告。
Let's bow our head and pray.
我们感谢上帝把这一幅图画摆在我们的面前。
We thank God that you have placed this picture before us.
让我们也听到警告的话语。
And we have also heard a severe warning.
天父上帝，求你保守我们。
Heavenly Father, please protect us.
希望当初美好的光景一直在我们的生活里面存留。
That the beauty before would stay on with us until the end.
求上帝保守我们。
We ask Lord that you keep us.
我们尝过上帝恩典的人。
We have tasted the heavenly gift from the Lord.
我们可以证实我们是相信你的人。
That we can prove we are believers.
也跟从你到底的人。
And followers to the end.
天父，你恩待我们每个人。
Father, we bless each one of us.
我们的处境好像希伯来的基督徒一样。
Our situation is just like that of the Hebrew Christians.
困难也一样会临到我们的身上。
Tragedy will also befall us.
但求上帝帮助我们。
But we ask Lord that you help us.
你既然在光明中帮助了我们。
You have helped us in the light.
你也在黑暗中一样指引我们。
You will also guide us when we are in darkness.
听我们的祷告。
Please hear our prayers.
奉耶稣基督的名。
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
我们来唱一首的诗歌，是441首。
We will sing hymn 441.
441首。
Hymn 441.
洁净我。
Cleanse me.
我们先请思琴 Joy 来弹一篇。
We ask pianist Joy to play for us once.
Thank you, Pastor, for the message and the hope that we will be encouraged by it.
下面是应答上帝话语的时间。
Let us now respond to the Lord by bringing forth our offering to Him.
以弗所书第四章第七节说，我们个人蒙恩，都是照着基督所量给个人的恩赐。
Ephesians chapter 4 verse 7.But to each one of us, grace has been given, as Christ apportioned it.
下面我们请四位姐妹上前受奉献，愿大家以感恩乐意的心奉献，纪念上帝为我们所做的一切。
We invite the four sisters to wait upon us. Please offer willingly and cheerfully, in gratitude of what God has done for us.
大家请起立，我们为奉献感恩祷告。
Please rise for the Thanksgiving prayer.
我们的天父
，Our Father in heaven，
我们感谢耶稣十字架的救恩。
Thank you for the salvation from Jesus on the cross.
我们感谢你在屋子上给我们丰富的赏赐。
Thank you for the abundant provisions.
现在我们献上的是你给我们祝福的一小部分。
Now we offer a small portion of your blessings.
愿我们的奉献能蒙你悦纳，用来扩展你的国度。
May this offering be acceptable to you for the extension of your heavenly kingdom.
我们如此祷告，是奉耶稣基督的圣名。
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
大家请坐。
Please be seated.
下面是些报告的事项。
Now it's time for the announcements.
同时请大家填写出席表。
Please fill in the attendance sheet at the same time.
我们代表教会欢迎首次和我们大家一起来敬拜的朋友们。请留下你们的姓名和地址，以便我们可以联络和代祷。
We welcome everyone, especially for people who are here for the first time. Please leave your name and contact details so that we can keep in touch and pray for you.
这个礼拜五上午十点半，我们有恩惠姐妹小组的聚会。
This Friday at 10:30 a.m., we have a Grace Chinese Ladies Bible Study Group.
在同一天礼拜五晚上八点，我们有弟兄英语小组的聚会。
Also on Friday at 8 p.m., we have the Men's Pilgrims Group.
我想说明一下，就这个，现在我们有两个组，一个是用英文的，一个是用国语的。
At this time, we'd like to mention that we have two small groups, one for English and one in Chinese.
礼拜六我们有Radiant 青年小组的聚会。
And on Saturday we have the Radiant Young Adults Group.
我们现在教会有一个网址，甚至在屏幕上面，大家可以到那边去看关于一些正道的一些录像。
Our church also has a website. If you look at the slide, that's the web address, and you can look to it for in announcements.
师母，我能请你上来一下吗
？Can I invite 师母 to come on stage?
所以是母亲的
坐在母亲边上
在我们结束以前我今天有一个特别的报告
Before we finish I have a special announcement to make
上个主日是我们堂建堂25周年的纪念日陈牧师代表教会向多年来在教会中心侍奉的长老们表达了感谢
Last Sunday was our church's 25th anniversary On behalf of the church, Pastor thank elders who have served this church diligently.
在会后长老们和执事们觉得呢我们好像忽略了一对非常重要的夫妇。
After the service, the elders and deacons felt that we overlooked an important couple.
所以对不起牧师
Sorry, Pastor.
在你不知晓的情况下面长老和执事们决定我们应该感谢陈牧师夫妇在过去我们堂25年来忠心的侍奉。
Without your knowledge, the elders and deacons decided that we should thank you for your faithful service to this church for the last 25 years.
所以我们也照陈牧师的样子做了一个 certificate.
So hey, Pastor, we also have a certificate.
我们还有一份小小的礼物。
And also a small gift.
我们下面我们请刘长老代表我们大家向陈牧师夫妇代表表示我们的感谢，赠送礼物。
Now we invite Elder Jensen Low to express our gratitude to them.
我想做一个小小的说明。
Thank you for all. Thank you for everything. Thank you.
大家都知道我是教会的财务，所以我想跟大家说明一下，这个礼物是由所有的长老和执事们拿钱出来的，所以这个资金不是从教会的账上出来。
Yeah. Everyone knows Chris is the treasurer of the church.And as the treasurer of the church, he would like to let the congregation know that the gift is contributed by all the elders and deacons. It is not from the church's account.
谢谢。
Thank you.
我想再耽误大家一会儿时间。
I'd just like to beg for your patience a little longer.
今天我要做一个关于财产基金的报告。
Today I would like to provide an overview of the use of our mission fund.
我们财产基金呢，主要有三个主要的用途，是支持宣教士，包括像苏永志牧师等。第二个呢是支持福音机构，第三个呢我们有一个神学教育基金。
The mission fund has three main purposes. Firstly, to support missionaries, including Reverend Yusuf Citra and to others. Number two, to support various para churches, and number three, to support the theological education fund.
所以现在在大家屏幕上面看到的就是我们这个财产基金今年的预算。
This is the budget for the financial year.
第一项呢是关于维多利亚长老会的总会的财产施工，这主要呢是用来支持长老会内外的有关福音传播的施工。 长老会属下的所有的堂会呢，都有按照他们的财政状况和能力分担这一事工。
Firstly, the General Mission Program is a program run by the Presbyterian Church of Victoria. It provides support to various missionaries and projects within and outside the PCV. All parishes are required to contribute to this program according to its resources and ability and with reasonable effort.
第二项呢，是我们支持长老会的神学院和墨尔本华人神学院。长老会神学院目前是训练和培养各种牧师、传道人和其他的教会领袖。墨尔本华人神学院是墨尔本神学院的一部分，负责与广东话和国语的神学教育。
Secondly, we also provide support for PTC and MST Chinese. PTC provides theological education with the purpose of training pastors for the local church, missionaries, and other church leaders.MST Chinese is part of Melbourne School of Theology and provides theological education in Mandarin and Cantonese.
我们还支持新，它是一个国际性的福音传播组织，在70个国家有超过4000工作人员。我们支持的 Neil， 他们全家曾在非洲的 Benin 从事福音工作超过10年。几年前他们回到了澳大利亚。Neil 现在是维省和塔斯马尼亚的。地区执行干事。
We also support SIM. SIM Australia is an international mission organization made up of more than 4,000 workers serving in nearly 70 countries. Our church supports Neil Sim, who served in Benin with his family for more than 10 years. They returned to Australia a couple of years ago, and Neil is now the regional director of Victoria and Tasmania.
今年的神学教育基金呢，是用来支持培理在长老会神学院的学习。那么大家要问谁是培理呢？他毕业于印尼的东南亚圣道神学院。明年2016年，他会在长老会神学院学习道学硕士课程。目前他正在长老会神学院进行一些短期的培训。同时呢，培理也在我堂的青年事工侍奉。比如说 BY 级中学组和年轻人组。
For this year, the Theological Education Fund is going to support Billy's study in the PTC. Who is Billy? Billy graduated from Southeast Asia Bible Seminary, Indonesia. He is going to study the Master of Divinity course in PTC next year, 2016. He has already started a short course in PTC.Billy also serves in our youth ministry, such as BYG and Young Adult Radiance Group.
今年我们财产基金的预算呢，有将近50,000块。我们财产基金今年筹款的目标是35,000，不足的部分是由前几年我们积累下来的资金补充。愿我们大家一起为此祷告，分享传播福音的事工。
For this financial year, our budget for the mission fund is close to $50,000. The target for this year is $35,000. The shortfall will be met by the savings that we put aside in previous years. Please pray for our mission fund and let us share the efforts to spread the gospel.
谢谢大家。
Thank you.
这就是我们今天所有的报告。
That's all for the announcements for today.
大家起立，我们一起唱翻译颂，然后由陈牧师祝祷。
We invite everyone to stand. We'll sing the doxology and we invite Pastor John for the benediction.